Hello, this is Dr. Atterberg, and in this presentation, we'll talk about the introduction to the course of mechatronics. Specifically, the course will highlight innovative artificial intelligence technology in mechatronics with business development applications. The training features of this course will cover mechanical electrical software basics. They also include state-of-the-art artificial intelligence machine learning concepts. They will include business development concept, use a free quick start online design analysis and machine learning tools. They'll use project management and business development tools. We'll experience hands-on project of mechatronics with artificial intelligence and machine learning features, and it is going to be based on my personal 40 years experience in mechatronics business development. Prerequisites, very simple, a desire to learn how to reach the stars. Ages, anywhere from 6 to 96. As Einstein once says, if you cannot explain the theory of relativity to a sixth grader, you probably don't understand it yourself. With that said, let's get started. The learning outcome that we expect in this course is use computer-aided design tools to quickly conceptualize and present mechatronics ideas, use finite element and sizing tools to quickly analyze the concept of the presented ideas, including precision, response, strength, and of course, correlation of the results to the variables, which is the essence of machine learning. We'll learn how to quickly build a printable proof of concept of mechanical models with electrical and software breadboard circuits using the Arduino. We'll implement and test literally within minutes, differentiating artificial machine learning concepts and features with free trial tools in a cloud such as Microsoft Azure. We'll learn how to protect our ideas with patent pending application. And also we'll see the highlight of business development planning in order to finance, develop, and launch our project. The mechatronic definition is shown here. It's a multidisciplinary field of engineering. It includes combination of system engineering, mechanical engineering, electrical, telecommunication, control, computer engineering, as well as advanced technology, which is being developed as we speak, in order to design a process or a machine that unifies all these subjects. Mechatronics requires, obviously, a team's work with an attitude of continuous self-learning. There's no one professor that can teach you the whole subject in one semester, one weekend, or maybe a month of training. You have to learn how to learn it on your own. And in addition, keep in mind that artificial intelligence machine learning may require an expert on your team to develop the model in the related field. The applications of mechatronics and artificial intelligence relate to virtually any conceivable field that you can think of, including consumer products, defense equipment, healthcare, manufacturing, retailing, transportation, education, agriculture, entertainment, and space exploration. There are endless of opportunities of using mechatronics to develop new intelligent products pretty much in any one of these fields. Let's take a look at the hardest subject in mechatronics and artificial intelligence. That is robotics and industrial automation. They are the top users of artificial intelligence and machine learning tools. A quick look at the history of this subject shows us that 200 years ago was the first revolution with the mechanization and water power and steam power. Then 100 years ago, then Ford came up with a mass production of assembly line of automotive. Then about 50 years ago, we saw the first robots with computer control. About 10 years ago, we noticed the fourth revolution of the industry with the cyber physical system fully controlled with Internet of Things that using with the upcoming 5G, very fast communication protocols that allow literally billions of things to communicate with each other like we do on the internet. Now, today, 2020, pretty much the name of the game is artificial intelligence and machine learning. And this is why we include it in this course. The different subjects that included in mechatronics are mechanical, electrical, computers, communication, and control. We see that Industry 4 started with advanced robotics with added smart sensors. We'll see how the artificial intelligence level expands into that. And in parallel, we see artificial intelligence getting today involved with handling many things together and use them to teach those machines how to learn different fields in order to help human to solve their problems. This is my personal view of the increasing scale of robotic artificial intelligence. And we see here the timeline as well as the level of intelligence. So starting about 100 years ago with just manipulation, robots could move point to point, but not too much intelligence to them. We developed about 25 years ago the robots with vision systems and various ultrasonic sensors. And that is the second level of intelligence, which is manipulation with sensing. Today, we are at the level of machine learning. This is what we'll be talking about. This is today, 2020, probably going into the 30s. And still we rely on human to make decision-making, which is a higher level of intelligence, optimization of our solutions, and also creative thinking. In 25 years, we probably will see that robots and automation could do decision-making and optimization to a level which competes with human. And then 100 years and beyond, we'll probably see, I'll call them U-bots, that are basically machines that can have creative thinking. The driving force of all of that is technological singularity in artificial intelligence. What it is that the inflection point where machines advance beyond human intelligence and thus become self-sufficient. That's where machine learning, artificial intelligence is driving at. And this is a trend of a rapid technological growth. Mechatronics is a major building block in artificial intelligence. And this course will train us how to become part of it. The following is an example of what we have to do when we come up with a new mechatronic project. This is a sample of a proof of concept. We have an idea, we have to prove ourselves that it is feasible. And here's an example of a proof of concept, which was pretty much conceived by myself with additional folks at Festo Corporation with a guy by the name of Matthew Quigley, which was the project manager. He was a mechanical engineering student at Stony Brook. He joined the company, and this was the job of project management that he did first, and it was patentable. We received the patent, and this is pretty much what you see here. It's a variable pitch gripper to an automated device. Here's an example of project management, again with a patent. You want to make sure that your ideas are being protected. It's a multi-purpose gripper in automotive production line that allows to save the manufacturer the time for changing tools, which takes 7 seconds, but 1 hour downtime at the automotive industry has a value of $150,000. So this particular device, which was done with a team at Festo Corporation, implemented at the automotive manufacturing, was another example of project management of a mechatronic system. Here's an example of a patent recently received. My name is on the list here with a team of Parker Hannifin, which was done for Goodyear, a tire rubber company. And the idea is based on Goodyear technology to produce a tire of the future based on filament winding. And our mechatronic invention related to standard Parker XYZ components with a smart software to wind the filaments on a tire at an optimal way. This is an example of a business development sample in mechatronics. This machine is designed for a solar panel, an automated device, was developed by a team at Parker Hannifin. A basic idea was of Anwar Chitayat, which has hundreds of patents and in automation, plus my personal patent to allow this machine to have large rotation as requested by the customer in order to maintain the accuracy at high speed. This machine is very large. It has 6 meters by 3 meters by 3 meters. And it runs at 3 meters per second, provides accuracy of laser printing of a few microns. 16 machines were developed and installed in fabs, two fabs in Germany and Sicily. Each machine cost is at the order of $1 million. You see here the concept. It has 24 smart sensors, extensive software, complex mechanical system. It's a complicated mechatronic system. And here you see the device itself. These are some examples of the type of analysis that engineers may have to do in order to optimize this their solution. It is available on my company's website. You click on that, you fill in the information in the yellow box, and you get the results on the blue boxes. And what this particular system does, it takes a mechatronic system of XYZ stages and it analyzes the accuracy of the system at the point of interest over here as a function of many other parameters. Here's an example of mechatronics component sizing tool, where we have in a yellow lines, we define the travel, the velocity, the acceleration, and so on and so forth. Over here, with a click of a button, we can choose some of the electronic components like motors and amplifiers. Over here, we see the results. Also, visually, we see the results, the motion results, and also the electrical results, whether we get all greens over here or red in the feedback section. will tell us whether we made a good design. This is a high-level analysis, which again is on Aptinet website. You click on a button and you can teach yourself very quickly how to use PID in a mechatronic system. This is the model which has a controller with a PID variables, and over here a mechanical device with mechanical variables. You place the variables over here in the system, and out you get the time response as well as the frequency response, and determine the stability of the system. This example shows us how to take an existing solution and make it a smart solution, more intelligent, by placing a smart sensor, acceleration, accelerometer, for example, and a thermal sensor right here at the tip of the cantilevered stages, which wind the Goodyear tire. And through wireless communication, telemetric, we send this to a cloud, which through a hub, which takes it from many sensors, take this information, stream it into an SQL database, which allow queries about the process, and also to machine learning model into the user interface. To show you what happens here in the AI machine learning arena, this chart taken from Clearview publication shows us that in 2017, there were like close to 15,000 patent applications. A few of them were granted primarily by Amazon, Microsoft, IBM, Google, but many others are trying to embed artificial intelligence and machine learning features into their product. And this is why we also included in our course. The mechatronic training structure in this course will include lectures to learn mechanical analysis, electrical sensors, signal conditioning, controllers communication, software skill sets, artificial intelligence, and excuse me, business development concept. The text we'll use is Mechatronics by Bolton, and then we'll also experiment a project to make and plan a preliminary design of a mechatronic product, do a detailed mechatronics and artificial intelligence design, go through the procurement of components, integration, and testing, and then optimize the device and present it. We'll use this tool set, electrical tool set by Arduino Uno. The example, the sample project that we'll take a look at how we go through all this process is taken in this particular course from the physical therapy market. And this particular example was developed specifically for the hand tool training of this course. We will do a market study to see similar hands-on devices such as vibration therapy. And then we'll come up with an innovative solution that actually combines isometric and vibration training in one device for machine learning, therapy, rehabilitation, and training of muscles and joints. And this was filed on September 3rd, 2019, just a few days ago, patented by myself, with an opportunity for the students to actually continue the innovation and make it an exciting product. We will see how the conceptual solution is being done using Quick Start computer-aided design tools. We'll also see how to develop the proof of concept model. This particular model was developed, built, and tested by one person, happens to be myself, in 1 week from August 25th to August 31st this year. And then we'll also learn how to protect our ideas with patent pending protection. And this particular one was written and claimed, patent pended in 3 days from September 1st to 3rd. And you see it includes a description of the electronic and mechanical components. The mechatronic projects sample model will show us how to define the parameters, how to define the variables, and how to look for the results. And then we'll take a look how we construct the model with neural networks, linear regressions, and some expert system rules. The criteria in order to protect our ideas, and the Office of Patents in the US and European Union struggle with that, but they recently came up with some guidelines. And I think the key point is that in order to protect your AI invention, it has to be related to process, has to be related to machine or to machine or to methods of manufacturing or to composites of compositions of material. It has to be useful, and it cannot just relate to laws of nature, physical phenomena, just be an abstract idea or just an abstract algorithm. The key in our case is a machine. We'll be using machine learning in a useful product with a useful process. The business planning is needed in order to apply our ideas to make this a better world. And we'll take a look at how we develop a business plan. This particular one example is going to be for the Apti IsoVibe business plan as the demonstrator product. And we'll take a look at the SWOT, which is the strength, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats in our device. And we'll take a look at the market that we are in, the engineering knowledge gaps that we have to actually close, and then the financial aspects of the product to actually raise the funds and build a product to later sell, manufacture, market into the business that we develop. This concludes our presentation. We would like to thank you for listening. And we'll continue with more of these lectures which relate to the course. Thank you.